അസ്സലാമു അലൈക്കും വറഹ്മത്തുള്ളാഹി വബറകാതുഹു. അൽഹംദുലില്ലാ വസ്സലാത്തു വസ്സലാം അലാ റസൂലില്ലാ വലാഹ്ലിഹി വസ്ഹാബിഹി അജ്മഈൻ അമ്മാ ബാദ്. Respected scholars, organizers, and my dear brothers and sisters, I welcome all of you for this very important session on the end of life, a new beginning. My dear brothers and sisters, we live in times today when there are many people who deny the existence of God, who say this life is everything. They don't believe in life after death. But we have iman in the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We have believed in the Quran, which is the book of Allah. There are many signs, many proofs for anyone with an open mind to see and believe that the Quran is the book of Allah, and to see and believe that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the true and last and final messenger of Allah, the creator of mankind. If we think of it, if there is no life after death, then the question arises, when we look at the universe above us, we can see that the universe has perfection. The way the whole universe has been created. How old is the universe? Science tells us, this report was early in 2017, it was 1377 crore years back the universe was created. 1377 crore years, with an estimate of 5 crore years plus or minus, the universe was created. The earth is about 450 crore years old, they say. Now what do we say? And science tells us today that the first second, the very first second after it was created, less than a second, fraction of a second, the forces, the gravitational force was set to where, how it should, how much it should be. The electromagnetic force was set how it should be. The small, the major and the minor nuclear forces were set into how much it should be. The balance, the constitution was set in less than a fraction of a second. It was planned and designed by the creator. Now my brothers and sisters, when we look at this universe, we see perfection. But when we look at the human world around us, we can see so much injustice. We can see so many people who are oppressors, who are tyrants, who are doing wrong things, and they are getting away with it. They are living happy lives. They live in a way laughing, and they even at times seem to be dying laughing. Now where is justice? We can see someone who is very poor, who doesn't have food to eat. He's living the life of a poor person, and there's someone who is very wealthy, someone who's beautiful, someone who's ugly, someone who's strong, someone who's weak. It's not all the same. Where is justice? We can see perfection there, but justice, injustice is imperfection. Where is justice? And justice is in the life after death. Justice is in the life after death. Those people who have done wrong, they won't get away with it. What do you think? Will Allah not punish the oppressors? Will Allah Ta'ala not give recompensation for what they've done? Will Allah Ta'ala not reward the righteous people? Today in this world, there are so many good people, people are laughing on them. But won't Allah give reward to them? There is going to be justice. And that justice is on the day of judgment. What is the proof of this justice? If someone doesn't believe in the life after death, we say, just look at the universe. Just look at this universe. It is giving us testimony about the perfection of the Creator. It is giving us testimony, and this Creator won't do injustice. Even the smallest degree of injustice won't be there. Tell me, what is more difficult? Is it more difficult to make the first time, or is it more difficult to make the next time, second time? What is more difficult? If you make something the first time, is it more difficult, or is it more difficult to make it the second time? The one who made it the first time, for him to make it again, is not difficult at all. He will do justice, complete justice. My dear children, it's very easy for you also to just sway and flow with the crowd. Everyone doesn't believe in life after death, and we also pretend and not believe. It's very easy to fail. But it's important for our own success that we pass. And we start with the verse from Surah Al-Imran, Surah number 3, verse number 185. Allah Rabbul Alameen tells us, Kullu nafsin dha'iqatul maut. Every soul shall have the taste of death. Wa innama tuwaffawna ujurakum yawmal qiyamah. You will get your full recompensation only on the day of judgment. Full recompensation is not there in this world. Partial may be there. Full is not there. Full is only on the day of judgment. فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ. Then he who is saved far from the fire of hell. وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةِ. And who is admitted to Jannah. فَقَدْ فَازَ. He is successful. He is successful. What is success? You want to be successful? All of us want to be successful? Say inshallah. Real success. You know what is real success? فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ. He who is saved far from the fire of hell. وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةِ. And is admitted to Jannah. فَقَدْ فَازَ. He is successful. وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاعُ الْغُرُورِ. For the life of this world is not but goods and chattels of deception. My children, there is so much deception around us. It's so easy to forget the purpose of life. It's to put your head in the ground like an ostrich and pretend not to see. So here we start our journey. The journey of life after death. And I'll ask you a simple question before starting. Suppose you are at your home. Where are you, suppose? You are at your home. Somebody knocked the door. You open the door. And he says, I knock just like this. Without any reason. What will you say? Huh? Something is? Seems to be wrong over here. It doesn't happen with normal people, isn't it? My children, this life is a test. If there is no life after death, there is no purpose to life. There is no purpose to life. It's aimless. Then what will happen? When you get success, you will become arrogant. And when you get failures, you will fall in depression. When you know where you are going, you don't fall into depression when there are downs in life. And you don't become arrogant when you get success, supposed success in life. Because this life's success is also a test. Let's start the journey. We will start from the time a person is dying. And at what age do we die? 60? Huh? What age do we die? Can it happen that a person can die young? Yes or no? I want to know practically, has any one of you seen anyone, any person who is young, have seen or heard any young person dying? In your real friends, raise your hand. Let me see. Allahu Akbar. How many? All of you have seen real people. I'm not talking of somebody in a real people at young age dying. Huh? People whom you know. See, so many experiences. And do you know? Jazakallah khair. Do you know? It could be you also. It could be you also. This life is an exam. Allah has not told us how much time we have. My children, listen to this. This is very important. In your normal school exam, college exam, how much time do you get? 3 hours. Now this exam, how much time are we getting? 20 years, 15 years, 30 years, 40 years, 50 years, 60 years. We don't come with an expiry date. Expiry date is? It's written? It's not written anywhere. Is this good or bad? It's very good. If we knew I'm going to die at the age of 60, then what will a person do? Say, if till 55 years, I'll just enjoy myself. Last 5 years, I'll get prepared to die. Last 5 years. 55 years, I'll just do what I want to do. But you don't know when you will die. And besides, even if we knew, the thing is, when the heart sins, the heart gets sealed. It reaches a stage when it can even get sealed. And then even if you want to think the right thing, you don't end up thinking. So it's good for us. Achha, tell me one thing. How big is life after death? How big? This is 50 years, 60 years, 40 years. Maximum 100 years, 110 years. What more can you get? How much is life after death? Huh? Do you know what's the meaning of limitless? How much is limitless? Very easy to tell. It's very serious. Children, my brothers, my sisters, don't lose this opportunity. One way traffic, you are only going, you won't get to come back. You won't get to come back. People will say, tell people who will go to Jahannam will tell, وَهُمْ يَسْتَرِخُونَ رَبَّنَا أَخْرِجْنَا نَعْمَلْ صَالِحًا. Oh Allah, send us back, now we will do good deeds. غَيْرَ الَّذِي كُنَّا نَعْمَلُ. We won't do deeds which we used to do. Now we will do good deeds, now we will offer salah, now we will believe in you, now we will think about life after death. But you get chance once, and in this chance you get many chances. You know ATKT? Do you know ATKT? Allowed to keep term. Do you have that system here? We have this in India. If you fail in some subject, they in college they push you to the next year. You can cover that up. Allowed to keep term. So for example, a person fails in one subject, go on, cover it up. A person sins, he does some sin, does he die immediately? No, allowed to keep term. Go on. ATKT, ATKT, so on, so on, so on, until a time will come when no more. So my children, you know who's a sensible person? Who prepares himself from now. You prepare yourself, keep yourself ready. Because we don't come with a expiry date. Achha, do you know, suppose for example, you want to buy some rice or some grains, and there are big gunny bags with all the grain. Now when you check, you will just check some grains. Okay, this is this quality, this is this quality, isn't it? If this life was 100,000 years, if we had to live for 100,000 years, not 60, 70, 80, 100,000 years, 10,000 years, 1,000 years, if we had big life, will the exam be easier or difficult? More tougher, isn't it? So Allah has mercy on us that He gave us this much life. If you have to have sabr, you have to strive, you have to control yourself only for 50, 60 years, then enjoy yourself. You die and then there's time to enjoy. Exam is over. Now relax. This is exam time. So if our life was 100,000 years, 1 crore years, it would make the exam more difficult. It would make the exam more difficult. So Allah had mercy, He has given us small life. With a few grains of that, you can test. And on the basis of that, there is a life which is forever and ever. Forever and ever. So let's start this journey very quickly. We'll run through. Of course, what is really needed is a full classroom session where every stage we discuss gradually. But that'll take a full one-day workshop. Today we are just going to give you some glimpses so that you feel interested about your real journey, where you are headed. Be focused. Don't lose your focus in life. Huh, my dear children? Let's start off. First thing, when a person is dying, what happens that time? Do you know? The ghaib, unseen. Can you see angels? When we do discuss Islamic things, now angels come and surround. Can we see them? Can we see them? No. But when a person is dying, his exam is almost gone, over. At that time, he sees angels. And there are righteous people and there are evil people. There are bad people and there are good people. Every single one of us is going to see these angels. Either the ones with bright faces, beautiful looking, good looking angels, who will come with a beautiful shroud. You know shroud, na? The kafan, shroud, which is very nice smelling. And they will come and sit, these angels will sit as far as your eyes can see. Where your eyes can see, na, they will be sitting over there. When you see these angels, you should know your time has come. This is the last time you see the angels sitting over there, as far as your eyes can see. And if a person is an evildoer, he will see the angels with very bad, ugly faces. And they will sit as far as his eyes can see. And when the time of death comes, the angel of death, Malakul Maut, he will come. And when he will come, he will not fail in his duty. He will draw out the soul. And how's the soul taken out? If a person is righteous, then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam explained, and there are 8 ahadith which I am referring to. The first hadith which I am referring to is by Anas bin Malik, which is in Sahih Bukhari and Muslim. The second hadith is by Bara bin Azib, which is in Abu Dawud. And all of these 8 ahadith are sahih, authentic ahadith. So I'm collectively telling you the full compilation of what is going to happen as told to us by our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He told us that the angels will take out the soul of the believer, like you can see from a sack of water, a drop of water, how smoothly it flows out. This is not a sack, this is a bottle. But you can see how smoothly one drop of water, how nicely, easily it flew out. You saw how easy it was. The soul of the believer will come out very simply and smoothly and easily. But the disbeliever who has done wrong, it is time of exposure. Now he has come to know I failed. And now he doesn't want to die. So it's given in the Quran in Surah Taha that the angels, أَخْرِجُ أَيْدِيهِمْ بَاسِتُ أَيْدِيهِمْ, they will beat him. Beat him. That leave your soul. And his soul will be drawn out. It will be torn out like you know, they're fanged this. You can, the way it's pulled out from wool, and how the threads come out. That kind of torturous ending that person is going to have, who's a disbeliever, who's a wrongdoer. And then the angel of death will take out the soul, and not for a blinking of an eye will it remain with him. The other angels, assistant angels which had come, they will take the soul from him. And for the evildoer, there are these ugly faced angels who have a very smelling shroud from the very, very rough fabric from the fire of hell. And which smells like the worst of the decayed corpse. The decayed corpse, you know, it smells very bad. It'll smell worse than that corpse. And in that person's soul, the evildoer's soul is put into that. And the good doer's soul is put in the soul, is in the put in that nice shroud. Then the angels will take. And then the journey starts towards the sky. And this is consequence. It's all consequence. And it's going to happen. We're going to see this happening either this way or this way. You have to decide which way you want. Decide now before it's too late. Don't leave for okay, I'll do it in the ending. You never know it'll end. So many hands you saw, na? So many hands we saw. Don't leave it for later. That's how Shaitan fools. Shaitan first tells, do wrong things. And then he says, okay, don't want to do wrong things. You want to do good? Okay, do good. But do later. You do good, no problem. But do later. Don't fall into the deception of Shaitan, my dear brothers and sisters. So now, they're taking the soul towards the sky. And as they're taking the souls, the angels who meet in between, the good angels, they ask, who is this? Who is this? This is so-and-so, the son of so-and-so, the righteous man. And this evildoer, who is this? This is so-and-so, the son of so-and-so. They're spoiling the name of your father also over there. Okay, son of so-and-so. And they are repulsed. And these, for the good soul, the angels are happy. Oh, he has come, so-and-so. And they are happy and they are welcoming him. Everyone is happy that he has come. Because you're getting a great reception. This is the ghaib, the unseen, what we believed in and which is true. Okay, then the soul is taken to the lowest heaven. For the righteous soul, it is asked, who is it? And he's so-and-so. And the gates are open for him. And they greet him, the angels greet him. And so on. Until every heaven he climbs up, until he reaches the last heaven. And over there, in the Illiyun, his record is written down. That this is his record, it's registered. But for this person, who reached at the last heaven, and the door was only not open for him. When they came to know he's so-and-so, the evildoer, the wrongdoer, the bad person, so the door was not open for him. And then his soul is thrown. It falls down, free fall, from the sky. And in a very disgraced and humiliated position, that he did not even get entry over there, he falls down, and until it falls down to the last of the earth, and this is all ghaib and unseen, and his record is written in the Sijjin. After the record is written, it is mentioned that take him and put him back in his body. And because Allah has said that Allah Rabbul Alameen has created us from the earth and he will put us back over there, and from there only we will be raised back to life. So his life, his soul is come and put back into his body. And when he is in his body, he comes back in his body, he hears the footsteps of people who have buried him. And they are going back. They left us and they went away. Nobody comes with you in the grave. Even your friend, even your father, mother, children, nobody is going to come with you. And me. All of us. May Allah save us from and give us honor on that day. So, is in the grave, alone. And this person, his soul is returned back to his body, and when he comes in his body, he realizes everyone has left me and gone. Now when they are in that state, what happens is that two harsh-faced angels come at that time. Two harsh-faced angels, and they start the questioning. They are Munkar and Nakir, the very strict interrogators. And they are going to ask the questions, Man Rabbuk, who is your Lord? And this person will reply, my Lord is Allah. And this one will say, I didn't know. Now even if you have attended today, and you know the answer, memorizing this answer won't help you until you don't really believe in it. And then will be asked, what is your deen? He will say, my deen is Islam. And he'll say, I don't know. And who is your prophet? He'll say, my prophet is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I believed in him, I saw the signs, I believed in him. And he will say, I don't know. Now there are hadiths with variations. We are not going to the details, my dear children. This has happened, and the angel will say that I knew that you will answer this. The angels will say that, and then the angels will go away after questioning. And this will be the last trial. And this is the last trial, and we see that Allah Ta'ala strengthens the heart of the believer and will give you help and strength. Allah will be there with you if you have really believed in Him. يُثَبِّتُ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Allah Ta'ala makes firm those who have believed. And my dear children, this thing of the ghaib, this is going to happen with every one of us. And then someone will come over there. In the grave, you're not going to be alone. A very good looking person will come for the person who's righteous. And he will say, who are you? So good looking you are. He'll say, I'm your deeds. And he will tell you that, see, a window will be opened. This is your place in Jannah. It will be told to him that, see, look at this place. This is your place in Jannah. When the day of judgment comes, then this place you are going to get. When he sees that I'm going to get this place, he will say, I wish the day of judgment comes fast. But for the other person, a place will be opened. A very evil looking person will come. And he will say, who are you? He'll say, I'm your deeds, the deeds that you used to do. My children, don't think that today what we do and nothing is going to happen. We're going to see the consequence, every single step that we go ahead in the Akhirah. Every single step we're going to see the consequence of our deeds. Now, what kind of person do you want over there? Decide. Okay, fine. We go ahead. This person, these are your deeds. And he's the person, he's coming. The deeds have come in the form of a person. And that person will show him. And as it said, it will be shown to him that this place you can see, this is your place in the fire. According to another hadith, we come to know that this person who is this righteous person, he's also shown a place in the fire. And he said that this would have been your place if you would have done these wrong things. If you would have walked on that wrong path. Now this way, it continues, and this person is excited. So it is said, now you relax and sleep like a bride sleeps. So he relaxes and he is resting. See, the way we need to know, my children, has it ever happened with you that you went to sleep and you woke up after many hours, but it felt as if my head just touched the pillow. My head just touched the pillow. It happens with us, isn't it? Because sleep is like death. Sleep is like death. And the dimension of time, 24 hours, 365 days, this is for our awake state, our living state. When you die, you are in a different dimension. Sometimes you have slept only for 15 minutes, but it felt as if I've slept for a long time. So there are people who have died from the time of Adam alayhi salam, and who are going to die till the day of judgment. Now that is, the person is thinking how much they are waiting. So they have entered the dimension of life after death, where the whole situation is very different. Okay, the dimension of time as we see it, and the clock and the timer, it doesn't work over there. Fine. So now this time goes until the day of judgment comes. Now we will have to very quickly look. See, my dear children, day of judgment, there are eight stages I'm going to describe, and I'm going to very quickly mention because time is very less. First stage. The first stage is Asa, the time, the hour. And do you know, when the day of judgment comes, it will come on the worst of the people. The worst of the people will be living, because the righteous people, before the day of judgment, they will all die. And only the worst of the people will live at the time of the day of judgment. And when the day of judgment comes, then all the surahs you read in the ending, the last para of the Quran, Amma para, you read the surahs, you will see is a samaan fatarat, when the skies are torn apart, wa idhal kawakubun tatharat, when the stars are scattered, and so on. When you read all of these things are going to happen then. The sky is going to tear apart, this earth is going to tear apart, these mountains, big and strong, they're going to fall down. You know, we read about the mountains. What do we read? We read that the mountains will all fall down. In another verse of the Quran, we see that they will be dust. In another, we see that they will be like a cloud. The dust will possibly will be like a cloud. Allahu alam. So we find, see that all of these things, these big things, horrible things are happening. And when you look at the universe, you can see every star has its life. Every star has its life. And science also tells us that this star of ours, the sun, is also not going to live forever. So it is scientifically also known that there is an ending. Allah knows when it is going to happen. Allah knows what will be the circumstances which will bring about the end of this world. But this world has not lived forever, has not been forever. There is nothing, only Allah Rabbul Alameen is the one who was forever. Huwa al-awwalu wal-akhiru. He's the first and the last. So this all is going to end. And all of these horrible things which we read, they're going to happen. That is stage one. I'll go rapid. Say stage two. Now, between stage one and stage two, there's a difference of 40. As mentioned in the hadith, 40. Now, 40 is what? These are 40 periods. How big they are, Allah knows best. In these 40, between the first as-sa'ah, it happened when the trumpet was blown. The trumpet was blown, Allah knows the kafiyah, but when that happens, then sa'iqa, then everything starts happening at that time. The ending came, that was the first, as-sa'ah. Then the second is al-ba'ath. And the second stage is when the second trumpet is blown. Between these two, there's a period of 40. We find in a hadith, authentic hadith, it's mentioned that in this period, there will be a type of a rain. And from the rain, everything which we are, it will get destroyed. Only the tailbone, a very small portion of the tailbone, it will stay back. And from this bone, we are going to grow. Do you know, plants, we see plants growing. We don't see plant has given birth and delivery of my plant has given birth, my tree has given delivery time. No. Allah wanted, in this world also, we could have been born like this. How we are born? We are born through birth. So there's a mother, there's a father, there's a brother, there's a sister, there are relatives. These are tests, and this is a help and comfort in this world. But on the day of judgment, we are not going to be born again, we are not going to be created again, but mummy is giving birth to a baby and the baby became big and then now he's married and now another. No. On the day of judgment, Allah is capable, we will be raised back to life again by growing. We will grow like a tree, a plant grows from that tailbone. And Allah is all capable. And we will grow until the bodies have grown. When the second trumpet is blown, our eyes will open. Our eyes will open, yours and mine and every single person, whether believer or non-believer. Every single person will be again living. And we will look and we will see this day of judgment which we heard about, which we believed in, has come. And that is al-ba'ath, the second stage of the akhirah. So we find that at that stage our eyes have opened and we are looking and Allah Rabbul Alameen has created us back, and then people will start moving forward. And as that is the third stage, al-hashr, the gathering. When people start going forward and they will gather. And that earth will be a different earth from this earth, as it's mentioned in the Quran. And Sahih Bukhari hadith, it will be like a yellowish, whitish, tinged, flat surface without any structures. That earth which is different from this earth, we will all be raised back to life. And the one who created us the first time, the one who made this huge universe, the one who makes the dead earth come back to life, the plants, and you can see the earth is dead and then the rain comes and the whole earth comes back to life, he can again bring us back to life. It's not at all difficult for him. And that is the demand of justice. There is going to be complete justice. So we are going to be raised back to life. And that is the day when people are yublisul mujrimun, that the evildoers, they will be humiliated. They will be humiliated, my dear brothers and sisters. We should not be from those people at that time. And we move forward to the hashr, the gathering. And the gathering is there. And we are moving forward. And all of mankind, they will be gathered. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that as we came in this world, we'll be gathered in that state. And we will be without any clothes. We'll be without any clothes, but no one will be bothered to look at another one. Because everyone will be in the state of horror that I'm going to see the consequence. My result day has come. This is the day, the horrible day, which had been forecasted for all the wrongdoers. So my dear children, That day has come and people are gathering before Allah Rabbul Alameen, the Lord of mankind. Al-Hashr. And then what happens? We move forward. That people are gathered and it's a very tough day. The day, as Allah says in Surah Ma'arij, that day will be equal to how many years? How many years? 50 what? 50,000 years. 50,000 years of our worldly life. That first day is 50,000 years. And you will be very thirsty over there. Huh? You will be very thirsty. And Allah says that the first one to be, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the first one to be clothed will be Ibrahim. And so on, people will receive back their clothes. And when we are raised back to life, it is not in this world, this way. For example, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, there will be someone who is arrogant, proud. There's someone who is proud. And that person, he will be like an ant on that day. His size will be small. He was very arrogant and proud in this world, never be. So similarly, someone did not see the signs of Allah. And he is raised up blind. He is raised up blind. So it is not necessary that you are going to be raised up like this, how you are looking, the same form. Maybe someone will be more beautiful and some good looking, and someone will be more ugly and very, very bad state. So my dear children, there will be someone who will be walking on his face. He won't be able to walk on his legs. Allah is capable. There will be people in different states on that day. And this is the Hashr, the gathering. And the day is 50,000 years according to our worldly life. There's a hadith in Abu Yala authenticated by Sheikh Albani, which says for the believer, this period of 50,000 years will be like the period between Asr and Maghrib. How much is that? For the believer, the true believer who believed in Allah, Allah will make things easy for him on that day. So we should know that that day can be easy for you, it can be very tough also for people. So my dear brothers and sisters, we go on the Hashr, the gathering. And then the gathering is in this state, people have gathered before Allah Ta'ala, but the judgment has not started. And then the mankind will go to different prophets. They will go to Adam alayhi salam first. Adam alayhi salam, you are the first man Allah created. Go to Allah and plead before him that the judgment may start and this whole thing is relieved. So Adam alayhi salam will say that I am not fitting for that. Go to Nuh. And Nuh alayhi salam will say the same thing. Go to Ibrahim, go to Musa, go to Isa, and finally they will come to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi salam. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi salam will go and will do sajda before Allah Ta'ala. He will accept, he will go and do sajda before Allah Ta'ala for a time that Allah wills. Then Allah will say, Ya Muhammad, raise your hand, raise your head and ask and you will be given. And intervene and do shafaat, intercede, and your intercession will be accepted. And Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam will raise his head and will do dua. Now, there's a very important thing about intercession which we need to know. This is an honor on the day of judgment. See, some people today, they say so and so great person will intercede for us and will save us. Remember this, my brothers and sisters. What will be the judgment? The judgment will be from Allah Ta'ala. The fair and final judgment is from Allah Ta'ala. Intercession is an honor for that person. You will find the righteous will be given a chance to intercede. Maybe if you are righteous and live a good life, you will get to intercede for people. But that doesn't mean that Allah wants to punish and you want to save, and then we will be able to save and anyone will be able to save and Allah wants to punish. Intercession is for whom Allah wills and by whom Allah wills. It is Allah's will. Only Allah is giving honor to that person, that this person is getting a chance to go and save that person. But the final will is the will of Allah Ta'ala. We should know this. So Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam will intercede and then the judgment will start. And my dear brothers, this is the fourth, brothers and sisters, fourth stage, which is al-hisab, the judgment. And in the judgment, entire evidences will be established. Proof will be established. Every single one. For the first proof, we will find Allah himself is a shaheed, the witness. Allah Rabbul Alameen is the witness and Allah Rabbul Alameen knows everything. So Allah Rabbul Alameen is the witness, and that is the first thing al-hisab, in al-hisab, that Allah Rabbul Alameen is the witness over it. And then there are the angels. Then there are the written books, the angels which are writing, kiram and katibin. And these books will be presented. And these books will be given in which hand for the righteous people? For the righteous people, which hand? Right hand. And we wish we get this in the right hand. And for the bad doers, whose accounts are bad, they will get their record in the left hand. According to another verse, min wara'i zahri, behind the back, but in the left hand. So we want it honorably before us in the right hand. And this is, he will be happy and rejoice and happy. I've got it in my right hand, alhamdulillah. We love this right hand, we eat food, we meet, we do musafaha with the right hand, we enter our homes and masjid with the right leg. So we wish that that right thing comes in our right hand. So we go ahead, the book is given, and we find that there are other witnesses. This earth is going to speak. This earth is going to speak and is going to tell. Our own body parts are going to speak. Our skins are going to speak. Our hands are going to speak. Our feet are going to speak. How will you hide? How will we hide, my brothers and sisters? Entire evidence will be established. Proof will be established. And mahu saikum wa shaheed. With everyone, when he was coming for the gathering, there was a driver and there were witnesses. So these witnesses are going to be established on us. And the Muslims are witnesses before all of nations about all the prophets of God, that they did pass on the message of truth. See, we are going fast, but pay attention. This is going to be happening in very slow, in a very, very long day, in a big day, which we are all going to see with our own eyes. So this day, the Hashr has happened, and now we are in Al-Hisab, the judgment. My dear brothers and sisters, I want to tell you a very beautiful hadith. The hadith of Sahih Bukhari, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, there is not one of you, but who is going to talk to his Lord directly, without any translator, without any intervention. He's going to talk to his Lord. And on his right side will be all his good deeds, and on his left side will be all his bad deeds. We are going to talk to Allah Ta'ala. Remember that day? If ever you think of doing bad deeds, remember that day when you're going to stand before Allah and we are going to talk to Him. What a great honor Allah Rabbul Alameen is going to give. What a big opportunity. What a great chance. And there are people who have done wrong and Allah will say, you did this. He'll say, yes Allah, I did this. You did this. He'll say, yes Allah, I did this. Until Allah will tell him, until that person will think, now I'm gone, how will I be saved? Allah will say, I forgive all of this. You know, Allah Ta'ala doesn't like one thing. If you publicize a sin and you create witnesses against yourself, then there's no chance. Evil spreads more. If you did anything wrong, never tell anybody. Because if you tell anybody, then you won't get this chance. This chance is only for those things which ever anything happens in secret, don't tell others, don't create witnesses. Then you're not going to be saved. Remember this very well. That if we have witnesses, then this chance opportunity is not there. Allah will say, I forgive you this. Allah is the one who covered it in this dunya, and He will cover it in the akhirah. So my dear children, this day, the day of judgment is there before us. And this is the stage, the fourth stage, Al-Hisab. Can we do revision quickly before going ahead? First stage? Al-Asa, the R, when all the things are going to happen. Then Al-Bas, when we are going to be raised up. Then Al-Hashr, the gathering. Then Al-Hisab. And in Al-Hisab, there's going to be a huge scale. Allahu Akbar. Have you heard this hadith? The Prophet ﷺ said that when Allah made the scale, it is bigger than the heavens and the earth. You get this? It's bigger than this. So angels will say, oh Allah, is there anyone who's going to have so many good deeds, so many deeds? Allah will say, those of my slaves whom I will. Huh? Do you know when we go for Salatul Janaza, and you go along and until the person's burial is there, what reward do we get? Who can tell? What reward do we get? Huh? You go in the Salatul Janaza and until the burial you are there. What is the reward? Huh? Two qirat. Like two mountains of good deeds. Two mountains of good deeds you got. Kalimatani. Two kalima, which are very easy on the tongue but very heavy in the scale. And do you know in the scale, all good deeds, they will be multiplied by at least 10. All good deeds multiplied by 10. Charity will be multiplied by 700. And fasting, you don't know what multiplication Allah Rabbul Alameen is going to give. And bad deeds at same value. But still, do you know, Allah Rabbul Alameen is going to give 10 times, yet most of mankind is going to fail. How greedy man is. How careless he is. Such a great chance Allah gave him that you do a bad deed, you seek Allah's forgiveness with sincere forgiveness, sincere repentance, and Allah is ready to forgive you till the last minute of your death. He's ready to forgive you. But when people come down to doing evil deeds, then they don't turn back away. So my children, the good deeds on one side, the bad deeds on the second side, and the full fair judgment. And after that, there's full retribution, and that's the fourth stage. And there it will become clear. You're going to go to Jannah, you're going to go to Jahannam. it's going to become very clear on that stage. And then we find that there is one thing which the Prophet ﷺ told, which I didn't mention, in this full period, was the Al-Hawz, which is, we don't count it as a separate stage, Al-Hawz. Every Prophet of Tabarani, Hadith of Tabarani, every Prophet is going to have his pond, Hawz. And they're going to give a drink from that to their Ummati, who believed in them. And Prophet Muhammad ﷺ is going to have Hawz Al-Kawthar. And this is the drink, the Al-Kawthar is actually a river of Jannah, and which will be in the form of a pond on the Day of Judgment, a very big pond. And Muhammad ﷺ is going to give with his own hands to the followers. And we have the chance and honor of drinking from the hands of our beloved Prophet Muhammad ﷺ directly. So the Al-Hawz, and if you get that, then that is great success, alhamdulillah, because there will be people who won't get it. And especially those people, there are different types of people who won't get it. Among them, very, very pronounced, are those people who bring new things in religion. For them, they will be stopped. ثُمَّ يُحَالُ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَهُمْ Prophet Muhammad ﷺ said, I will be stopped from them, and they will be. I will be told, إِنَّكَ لَا تَدْرِي مَا أَحْدَثُ بَعْدَكَ You don't know what new things these people have brought in religion. Because these people brought these new things in religion, the Prophet ﷺ, when he will come to know this, he will say, سُرْخًا سُرْخًا لِمَنْ غَيَّرَ بَعْدِ Go away, go away. Those people who brought new things in religion, you brought new things in religion, you go away. So this is the fourth stage, Al-Hisab. After Al-Hisab, everything is clear that who's going to go where. But there is more. When we see that the evildoer, the kuffar, those people who have rejected. And remember one thing, my brothers and sisters, Allah doesn't do injustice to anyone. Allah doesn't do injustice to anyone. Those people who rejected, they will go on their way to Jahannam. They will be they will be driven to Jahannam. And when they reach there, the gates of Jahannam, they will be asked, at that, Alam yatikum nadir, did not any warner come to you? So they will say, Qalu bala qad jaana nazir. No, warners came to us. Warners came to us. There's a beautiful hadith in Musnad Ahmad which Imam Ibn Kathir has mentioned in commentary of Surah 17 verse 15, which is mentioned that that Allah says that وَمَا كُنَّا مُعَذِّبِينَ حَتَّى نَبَثَ رَسُولًا I'm not going to give azab until I don't send a messenger. You will not get azab until I don't send a messenger. This hadith in Musnad Ahmad, it mentions a very beautiful scene. Remember and visualize this. Four kinds of people are going to argue with Allah. One will say, Allah, I was born in the period when between two prophets. And Islam, I did not get the message of Islam only. Second person will say, oh Allah, Islam came to me, but I was deaf. I just could not hear anything. The third will say, oh Allah, I was slightly mentally deficient. It came to me, but I could not understand anything. And the fourth person who was very old, he'll say, Islam came to me, but I was so old, I just could not understand. So these are different categories of people. So these people, when they will say this, Allah will say that no injustice will be done to you. This day, after seeing all of this, this is my messenger. He will tell you, listen to this messenger, this angel. Whatever he tells you, listen to him. Allah has told us. And that angel will take them to a place where they will see the fire and they will be told, jump. And those of them who jump will go to Jannah. And those who don't jump will go to Jahannam. Because these are the inclinations which they developed in their lifetime. Huh? These are the inclinations, and according to that, they are going to do this action. So Allah is going to be very fair. It may be you see some non-Muslim who's your neighbor in this dunya, and maybe he really didn't get any message of Islam. He just didn't come to know what is the true message. If he came to know, he rejected it, then there's no way of saving himself. But if he didn't come to know, maybe he will jump, and he was a righteous good man who was ready to obey Allah, and maybe he'll be saved and he will go to Jannah. You don't know, maybe he'll be your neighbor in Jannah also. So we see, this is the fairness and justice which is we get to know, and scholars have talked about this. And let's go ahead. So those people who go to Jahannam and the others will go forward. They'll go forward to something which is called Pul Sirat. Pul Sirat, there will be the believers and the hypocrites who have gone ahead. Those people who are hypocrites, they have also gone ahead. And the believers who have gone ahead. And then what will happen is that the Pul Sirat is a bridge over Jahannam. Every one of us has to pass this bridge. Now if you think that, you know, tightrope walking. You tie a rope and you walk on it. So if you practice well, then do you have better chances of crossing the Pul Sirat? Huh? If you know how to balance yourself on this tightrope, you have better chances of crossing Pul Sirat? No. That is according to our deeds. It is according to our deeds. So Pul Sirat, for the righteous person, it will be very easy. Some will be crossing it like the blinking of the eye. You blinked it, cross ho gaya. Easy. He's crossed. Then saw someone, they will be like lightning. Gone. Crossed. Gone to Jannah. Alhamdulillah. And for some, it will be like fast horses. And for some, they will go slow speed. And last, there will be people who will be crawling. And the pul sirat, if you are a righteous person, then we find that there is light according to your iman. And if you don't have iman, then you will be in darkness. And the pul sirat also is very slippery. It's very slippery. The Prophet ﷺ told us. And he also told us that it, on the sides it has hooks which pull down. And if you get stuck in one of those hooks, then you can fall off into Jahannam. My dear children, it's very easy to lose focus and be involved in this, the colorful life over here. But fact is, we see the colorful life and we remember Allah Ta'ala. We remember the day of judgment and live our life according to that. So that is the pul sirat, the gathering. And we go further. Now the believers have crossed and now they will reach ahead. Now there's a very important hadith of Sahih Bukhari, which many people don't know of, that there's a small bridge called Qantara. And Qantara is the bridge where if you have done anything bad to people, it will be recompensed. If you've done any bad, that kind of settlement is going to happen. So he will say that this person abused me. He did ghiba. He hit me. He did zulm on me. And remember, zulm is done in this dunya, which is very small. And justice is done in akhir on the day of judgment, the day of 50,000 years. And we have to pay back from our deeds. And deeds are in shortage. Yawma yafirru al-mar'u min akhihi. The day a person is going to run away from his brother, wa ummihi wa abi, from his mother, from his father, wa sahibatihi wa bani, from his wife and husband, and from their children. We are going to run away from them. This day, the day of judgment, is the day when one person is not ready to give one deed. But if you've done zulm, then you have to give from your deeds. Until the Prophet ﷺ said, there will be a person who will have come with lots of good deeds, but he has done zulm and qad shatama hadha wa daraba hadha. He has beaten so one and abused so one, and everyone, he has to do justice, he has to pay out. Until the time will come that all his deeds, which were so many, will be paid out, and yet people are coming. So now what? That person has done wrong thing. His sin will be taken and put on this person. You bear his sin. I did not do this sin. You didn't do this sin. He did this sin. But you have to bear this sin. Why? Because you did zulm on him. Now bear, it's the day of judgment, the day of justice. Full justice is going to happen. So the sin of that person, maybe this person did zina and he's going to bear that sin of that zina. He didn't do that zina. Someone else did, but he did zulm on him. So my dear children, never do zulm on anyone. Never do zulm on anyone. Never do any injustice of the smallest degree on anyone. Because Allah is going to recompense even the smallest bit of injustice. And this thing will be done. And this is the stage of the before entering Jannah. And then will come the stage of entering Jannah. And the first person to enter Jannah is going to be our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It will be said that this door was not going to be opened for anyone other than you. And he's going to be the first person to go to Jannah. But there will be some believers who have done wrong things and who will land in Jahannam. And they will get punishment in Jahannam, but they did not deny Allah. You know, treason, gaddari, treason. If someone that does treason, the governments don't leave him. The treason in the court of Allah Ta'ala is shirk and maduna dhalika. Below it, anything which is of the same level, shirk, kufr, and real nifaq. So they are all of the same level. If a person has done shirk, has joined partners with Allah, he has done kufr, he has rejected Allah, so what will happen? There's no chance of him going to be saved. But he didn't do shirk, he's a believer, but he had more sins. So he will go in Jahannam. Until he gets his punishment, then he will be removed from it. And there will be different people who will come to remove him as honor. The prophets will remove, the angels will remove, the believers will remove. And in the ending, Allah Rabbul Alameen will say, anyone who has an atom's weight of iman in his heart, Allah is going to remove him from Jahannam. Even atom's weight of iman. My dear children, you know some people, what they say? They say, last minute they will go to Jannah. No? So fine, I'll take this route. But there's a risk in this plan. What is the risk? Do you know, scholars say this, when a person does sins, knock on the door of kufr. Sins knock on the door of kufr. A person starts with sin and then he rejects the truth. So many people, you say, this is wrong, don't do this. They say, it's my fault. It's my fault. It's my fault. Then one day he says, I don't believe in this. Gone into kufr. So it started with sin, it went into kufr, it goes into kufr, you're not going to come out of Jahannam. And a person gets, who wants to enjoy the Jahannam, the fire of Jahannam, which is 70 times more powerful than this fire? Who can bear that? For even 1 second, who can bear it? So your plan to Jannah is how? Direct or via Jahannam? How you want to go to Jannah? Direct or via Jahannam? 4-5 people want to go to Jahannam directly. The rest others? Direct you want to go to Jahannam? Direct you want to go to Jannah? Or via Jahannam? Okay, so many people. MashaAllah. Others? Direct or via Jahannam? Remember this, inshallah. Directly we want to go to Jannah with a heavy scale. Heavy scale, and Jannah has different levels. And every level will be like, okay, you can see the stars here. That is one level and this next level of Jannah. Until the highest level of Jannah is? Highest level of Jannah is? Jannatul Firdaus. So where you want to go? Jannatul Firdaus, inshallah. It is easy. If you want to do it, Allah has opened the way for us. So my dear children, we find that there's this stage of people who go to Jannah directly, and there's this stage of people who go to Jahannam, and via Jahannam they go to Jannah. Finally, we will see that these are the different stages. I'll just count them once again so that some things have got mixed up in between. We have the first stage when everything is going to happen and this whole world is going to come to an end. That is Asa, as scholars have explained. There are different ways of looking at it. Second, Al-Ba'ath, when everything will come back to life. Third is Al-Hashr, when people gather. Fourth is Al-Hisab, the accounting. And fifth, we find that we count Al-Hawz as a separate stage, the Hawz Al-Kawthar, which will be there all along. And sixth, we find the Jahannam, people of Jahannam going to Jahannam and the others going to the Pul Sirat. And after Pul Sirat, there is the Qantara, the small bridge. And then there are people who go to Jannah directly, and there are people who go to Jahannam and they come out and then they go to Jannah. So this is in short. Of course, there are many more details. We need to look at it more in detail. But what thing we want to share with you is that firm and confirmed Iman, the sure Iman. And I'll end with the verse from the Quran. Allah Rabbul Alameen has said in the Quran, Inna sa'ata la atiyatul la raiba fiha. Surah Mu'min, Surah 40, verse 59. That the hour, the day of judgment is coming. There is no doubt in it. There is no doubt in it. May Allah bless us with the wealth of truth, live lives of righteousness, and then bear and get the fruits of righteousness, that is success of the Akhirah. Ameen wa akhir dawana, and alhamdulillah rabbil alameen.